The education sector is right now behind the curve in terms of what India needs. Education in the United States is going towards education 3.0. India is still stuck in 2.0, the educational architecture of the 19th century. In the 21st century, you need a new kind of architecture based upon technology, since all students have access to information on the web. They have access to flipped classrooms, to rich lectures, to MOOCs and everything else. They probably know much more than their teachers in terms of information. And that's why I believe that the education sector is behind the curve. We have not seen reforms since 1991 in the education sector. We've seen reforms in industry, in technology, everywhere else. But the education sector is really behind. And even in this new government, after 2.5 years, we have not seen much change. And today, the education sector is not meeting India's needs. It's churning out a large number of unemployable graduates, giving very poor education to our children. And the biggest sufferers are the poor people because they depend on government schools and government educational institutions, while the rich gravitate towards private schools where they get a better education. If you look at the PITHM studies, about 40-50% of people in children in class 4 and 5 do not know how to do ordinary maths. And what future can a country like India have if our children, who are going to be around for the next 60 years, for whom this government exists and society exists, are not well educated and well trained? So I think the biggest human resource tragedy on this planet is being played out in India. Let me give some data. Out of 100 children who enter class 1, only 70 finish class 12. Only 70% of that pass, that is 50 out of 100. Out of them, 40 finish class 12 and about 25 go to college. That means 75 don't go to college. And out of 75, possibly about 30 don't even finish class 10. So I think we need a wholesale ramping up, wholesale change and improvement in quality, and we need to have a new architecture. Well, technology funding is lacking in India in a large way. Out of $10 billion last year, only $500 million came from Indian capital. The Indian capital, in my view, is a rent-seeking class. They don't want to take risk. Many of the cronies take risk with bank money, but they don't want to raise the capital. It's surprising that not much money is coming technology. Even though we have technology giants in this country, we have many entrepreneurs who have created, we are billionaires because of technology, they're just not investing enough. So our investment bankers in this country are behind the curve in terms of understanding the role of technology. Today, India is under threat of becoming a digital colony dominated by Western capital and now Chinese capital. If Indian capital does not come in, Indian capital does not work, I'm afraid in the next 5 years, we'll become a digital colony dominated by China, because China is pouring enormous amounts of money. And if you look at the top 10 largest companies in the startup space and technology space, the new age companies, you'll find a great majority of them are owned by Chinese capital. The Japanese are coming in a small way. We're also seeing American capital come in very, very large way. Yes, they're all capitalists who want a great return. But when you have Chinese capital, then they could lead to control and other issues. So unless Indian capital comes up, the Indian market, which is a large, great digital frontier in the world, will be dominated by overseas capital, and India may well become a digital colony. And I think it's very important for Indian capital to come in and the Indian investment bankers to understand what is happening in this country.